was your night?
Huh?
How was your night?
Warm and toasty.
Ah, that's good. That's good. Oh, God. Yeah. As you can see, that the tarp, lads, is absolutely destroyed with pine needles and bits of sticky and everything. But, it constantly rained yesterday, didn't it? It didn't stop for 2 minutes.
No, it really
didn't stop raining now, actually, is it? The rain has just stopped now, but there's a lot of water flowing over there. Whereas that's normally only a little teeny trickle. Oh, God. Right, lads, I'm going to get a cuppa on and tidy up camp a bit, and then we'll get the breakfast on. So, see you in a bit. You slept all right anyway.
I did. I bring the stuff set next time, I think. It's a little big.
Yeah. Nice sleeping bag though. What'd you pay for that again?
€50. Then another €57 to ship it.
Crikey. And well, what model is it?
It's one of these American modular sleep systems, they call it. It's an intermediate sleep. Intermediate sleeping bag, and there's this heavy duty sleeping bag, and there's this Gore-Tex sleeping bag out front, and it's fixed down the side. Some of the huge ones will just go straight down the hole at the front. This one is better because it can go in the side of it.
Right.
It's easier to get into it. And they come in different sizes as well. I found that afterwards.
Really?
Yeah.
Did they do super fat?
I presume they do, extra large.
I should be able to get one of my legs into that, so. Oh, God. The old brew, lads.
Breakfast.
The wind and rain have died down anyway.
It's very peaceful actually.
So I would say there's more on the way though. I hope it holds off till we break camp, you know. Calm down about 3 times last night.
Dave picked up. Calmed
down. And it picked up, and it was howling. I'd say that was near 50, 60 mile an hour winds up here last night.
It was strange because we got used to it. You know, it was like normality, the howling in the background.
Yeah, yeah. Because as I say, Met Erden, they said it was going to be 40 mile an hour winds, or it was a 40 mile an hour, 40 kilometres, but it was definitely more than that last night.
Yeah, I was sitting, this, I could feel it going, as the two trees are bending back and forth in the wind.
Yeah. You finished your cup already?
I scuffed the dumpster in there.
Oh, good.
Give him a sit in this, and trees are bending back.
I was laughing because I was watching, I was sitting over here. You were asleep, and I could see the hammock going off and down. Yeah. Off and down.
When it first started, it was kind of strange. Isn't it? That
Then I went down, I had a look with the torch and the trees where they were.
Yeah.
You know, they were swinging.
Oh, trees, yeah. That's about 40 feet high.
Oh, yeah.
They're catching the wind, ain't they? While catching the wind. Should all trees blow down inside there?
Oh, there's a load of dead falling. A load of dead falling. Nice bright morning out there. You see, the full brightness never gets in here with the canopy.
Right. Usually, not a frost I got, there's no green on the ground at all, it's all brown, eh?
You want to lift that off the ground because that will get saturated.
It's saturated, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, I don't mind the tarp being wet, you know, that's the only wet thing to pack up, but I hate getting any of the gear wet, that's why I hang everything up, you know. We're lucky now if it stays like this till we break camp. That should do. Definitely get the big hammock, so yeah. Okay. Oh, sorry, the big tarp.
Yeah.
That's the 4.5 by 4.5 meter one.
Get a parachute.
Oh, a parachute would be the job, like the lads.
Huge.
Like that camp buzzer.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be. You'd want a good wide area. You would. You couldn't have it up here. No way in God's earth could you? Have the proper fire in it then, you know.
That's a nice flat going down there as well.
Nah, there's nothing around. As I say, I love coming up here, but it's just so darn damp. And when you set camp, there's nothing to do.
Not you can't.
Because the wood is, you know, the wood is rotten, the ground is unstable. But hey ho, you know, it gets you out for a night or a couple of nights. Which, after all, is the main idea, I suppose, but... May as well get a bit of breakfast on there in a few minutes. For Paul's video there, 51 Foxy. Tag me on the Bushcraft Breakfast. My bushcraft breakfast won't be much, Paul, because I don't eat breakfast. I only eat my dinner once a day, and that's usually about 10 o'clock at night. I'd like to wish all my subscribers, and all Andrew's subscribers, Solo Bushcraft Andrew.
Happy Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas, lads. A Happy New Year. And thank you for all the Christmas cards. Had about 40 of them now so far, and very, very nice of you. Couple of shout outs there, Tom. Thanks very much, Tom. Quality Jackson sent me some lovely little survival cards in my Christmas card. And thanks to Paul 51 Foxy, sent me a couple of those lovely S-beaners, Andrew.
Was this
thing
you were hanging up everything with?
Yeah, the S-beaners, yeah. They're brilliant. Thanks a million for that, Paul. And a special thank you to Les and Marilyn. Fepos One. That's all I say. Thank you, Les and Marilyn. Thanks a million. And just as a special shout out to a very nice lady out there, Rockchick37. That's Rockchick37. That's Anita. Hi Anita. Love to the kids, Anita. I hope you have a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And keep up the good paracord work anyway. We all love watching you make it. You make some great stuff anyway. So we'll have to get Andrew started on the paracord walk now on. But right lads, we'll finish the coffee and have a bit of a tidy up around camp, which is looking impossible at the moment. We could just go back to bed there for about an hour, I'd say. But
for a power nap.
We'll wake up a bit and then make a bit of breakfast. See you in a bit, lads.